There was a garden there, and he and his disciples entered it. The place was familiar to Judas, one who was the handover, because Jesus had often left there with his disciples. Judas took the cohort as well as cards supplied by the chief priests and the Pharisees and came there with lanterns, torches, and weapons. Jesus, aware of what all had happened to him, stepped forward.
Who is it you want?
Jesus of Nazareth!
I am he.
Now Judas, the one who was to hand him over, was there right there. As Jesus said to them, I am he, they retreated slightly and fell to the ground. Jesus put the question to them again.
Who is it you want?
Jesus the Nazarene.
I have told you, I am he. If I am the one you want, let these men go.
This was to fulfill what he had said. I have not lost one of those you gave me. Then Simon Peter, who had a sword, drew it, and struck the slave of the high priest, severing his right ear. The slave's name was Malchus.
Put your sword back in its sheath. Am I not to drink the cup the Father has given me?
Why do you not take him and pass judgment on him according to your law?
We've been
not put anyone to death.
This was to fulfill what Jesus had said, indicating a sort of death who would die. Pilate went back into the praetorium and summoned Jesus.
Are you the king of the Jews? Are you saying this on your own, or have others been telling you about me? I am no Jew. It is the chief priests and your own people who have handed you over to me. What have you done? My kingdom does not belong to this world. If my kingdom were of this world, my subjects would be fighting to save me. As it is, my kingdom is not here.
So then you are a king?
It is you who say I am a king. The reason I was born, the reason why I came into this world, is to testify to the truth. Anyone committed to the truth hears my voice.
Truth? What does the truth mean?
Speaking for myself, I find no case against this man. Recall your customs whereby I released to you something at Passover time. Do you want me to release to you the King of the Jews?
We want Barabbas, not this one.
Barabbas was a revolutionist. Pilate's next move was to take Jesus and have him scourged. The soldiers then mowed the crown of thorns and fixed it on his head. The run around his shoulders, a cloak of gold and purple. Repeatedly, they came up to him and said,
Away with him. Crucify him.
What? Shall I crucify your king?
We have no king but Caesar.
In the end, Pilate handed Jesus over to be crucified. Jesus was led away, and carrying the cross by himself, went out to what is called the place of the skull, in Hebrew, Golgotha.
There they crucified him, and two others with him, one on either side, Jesus in the middle.
Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews.
This inscription in Hebrew, Latin, and Greek was read by many of the Jews. Since the place where Jesus was crucified was near the city, the chief priests of the Jews tried to tell Pilate, "You should not have written the King of the Jews, right instead of his name, the King of the Jews."
What I have written, I have written.
Said,
"Now it is finished."
afterward Joseph of Arimathea.
A disciple of Jesus, although a secret one for fear of the Jews, asked the Pilate permission to remove Jesus' body.
Pilate granted it, so they came to fly away.
Nicodemus, the man who had first come to Jesus said that he likewise came to bring the mixture of myrrh and aloes which lay about the
body. They took Jesus' body and
brought
it to the Jewish burial custom. They bound it up with wrappings of cloth.
The place where he had been crucified, there was a garden, and in the garden, a new tomb, which no one had ever made.
Because of the Jewish Preparation Day, they laid Jesus there, for the tomb was empty.